This piece is called the Light Song, and we also affectionately call it the People's Chandelier.
The purpose of Crystal Palace is really to reinvent the concept of the chandelier, but to also show what role Swarovski crystal can play in the creative process that designers usually go through when developing new products.
When we first presented the idea to Swarovski, there was kind of a dead silence around the table. But I think that almost immediately everyone realized this was such a clear, simple idea that it would have iconic value, it would sell, everybody would understand it as a chandelier.
The inspiration behind it was to rethink a convention of lighting that was actually, you know, quite old, and it's transformed over the centuries. It's at a point where the chandelier has kind of lost its luster and lost its edge. And we wanted to see if we could reinvent it in a way that's a little bit more characteristic of our time.
We're asked to design a chandelier, and the way we think of chandeliers was not something that we could do. And began to explore how else could crystals be used. And at some point, through a lot of experimentation, we ended up dumping them into a mesh bag, and that was the beginning of it.
We knew we wanted to make a chandelier in a traditional sense, hang something, but what we wanted to do was strip it of its decorative value and really release the light quality that you get out of crystal. Fragmentation of light, the sparkle, the rainbow effect.
Walking in here is glorious because you feel this burst of light and you realize that something very, very new has happened.
We wanted something to hold on to the sparkle, but be tough. It's something I would want to hang over at my own table. Something that would be more contemporary in today's world, because most of the crystals, when I see all the pendants hanging down, I think Versailles, it's a throwback. I think we wanted to push, at least from my point of view, we wanted to push forward.
I think it's really so unusual and interesting and exciting, because what Dillard's Cofidio did was they actually broke down the idea of a chandelier. A chandelier is a structure that holds these crystals, but instead they're just offering a bag of them, almost a random bag, of sort of by weight. They've undermined the concept of what a chandelier is and supposed to be, so I think they've turned it into a type of conceptual work. And so it's exciting because it's an idea, and the idea is basically undoing what was supposed to be.
It's absolutely correct to call it the People's Chandelier, because people really respond so positively towards the chandelier, whether it's the two-year-old child or the adult. And, you know, I think people are left in awe, or people stand in front of the product in awe.